Greetings. This is Reason to Reject Islam, number 15, The Worthless Love of Allah. I listened to an Islamic Dawa video featuring Mansoor at Speaker's Corner in Britain. In it, Mansoor mentioned one of Allah's 99 names, Al-Wadood, or Al-Wadood, the most loving, the one who is the source of all love and affection. His love is intense, constant, and lasting. Does that sound great or what? The one who is the source of all love and affection. Now, think about that a moment. Whose voice is this? I mean, who does it sound like is saying this? Does it not sound like a person attempting to just describe a superlative? A sycophant might as well be inventing, Allah is the one with the longest fingernails. But rather than be carried off in fanciful imaginations and inventions of, my Allah is better than, hyperbole, let's look at what the Quran actually says about the love of this imagined Allah. Surah 3, 159. Verily, Allah loves... Whoa, dear Muslim, please do not only read two words and then shout, Allah be praised! Allah loves! The claim of the name Al-Wadood is that Allah is the source of love. This surah may not carry any implication of sourcing or receiving love. Read the whole ayat and see what Allah loves or does not love. Verily, Allah loves those who rely upon Him. Logically, an affirmative statement regarding one position does not assert the negative or the opposite. Saying, I love dogs, is not also saying I hate cats, regardless of Kathy Newman-like techniques to say, so what you're saying is you hate cats. So saying I love those who rely on me says nothing about those who do not rely on me. Allah may love, or Allah may hate. Or Allah may be indifferent to those who do not rely on Him. However, the intentional omission of mention of the conjugate, or opposite case, cannot be completely ignored. We must assume all statements in the Quran by Allah are intentional. Allah, therefore, intentionally restricted his statement about those he loves. This speaks only of his love for those who rely on him. It should therefore never be stretched to assert or guarantee Allah's love beyond those who rely on him. One cannot say that Allah is the source of any and all love in those who do not rely on Him. Keep that in mind when you read and attempt to interpret the Quran, or any other text for that matter. Surah 376, Nay, those that keep their plighted faith and act aright, verily Allah loves those who act aright, or in other translations, righteously. From this we only know that Allah claims to love the righteous. This speaks nothing of any love for the unrighteous. Surah 2, 195. Behave well. Verily, Allah loves those who are good. Just like Santa Claus. If you are good first, then Allah will love you. Essentially, if you are good first, you earn Allah's love. He will love you. This leaves the open begging question. If you stop behaving, or even ever misbehave, does Allah stop loving you? If you must earn Allah's love to get it in the first place, why would Allah continue to love a misbehavior? Remember, from a statement, Allah loves the believers, we could only make inference regarding his attitude toward believers. Such a statement reveals nothing of his position on unbelievers. Kindly allow Allah to remove all doubt from your thinking. Surah 332. Verily, Allah does not love the unbelievers. Verily, Allah does not love the unbelievers. Do you think that could be any clearer? Surah 2, 276. Allah does not love any ungrateful sinner. So much for an all-loving
Allah.
Surah 60, verse 8. Verily, Allah loves those who are just. How does Allah know if you are just? Allah must watch what you do. Be just, and then Allah will love you. Unless you fail in some other area. Surah 564. Allah does not love those who spread corruption. We now know that Allah hates CNN. At least Allah got that right. Surah 2, 190. Verily, Allah does not love the transgressors. The list of those Allah does not love goes on and on. Surah 3, 140. Allah does not love the oppressors. But I bet Allah loves those who oppress to spread Mohammedism. Surah 4, 107. Verily, Allah does not love those who are treacherous sinners. Surah 2, 222. Verily, Allah loves those who repent, and purify themselves. It's just easier that way. Purify yourself first. Then Allah will love you. To a Christian, that statement is asinine. The God of the Bible says you cannot purify yourselves. Think about this. Islam tries to claim Allah is Al-Wadood, the one who is the source of all love and affection. But Allah does not even love those who do not love him first. His love is intense, constant, and lasting. These sound more like an imaginary romance novella definition. Intense. Allah's chest heaved in passion. Lasting, as long as you continue to earn his love. The favor and affection of Allah is worthless because it is no different from and no better than the love a human being gives and practices. We can love those who love us first. We can easily love those who prepare themselves to meet our expectations and demands. I am completely unimpressed regarding Allah's imaginary, so-called love. Allah's love is entirely pathetic compared to Jehovah God's love. Allah's love is human love and nothing more. And the Quran details many more cases of folks Allah does not love. If Allah does not love, the Allah of Islam cannot be the source of love in that relationship. And that is why this is reason number 15 to reject Islam, the worthless love of Allah. May the Spirit of God, Jehovah, the one who is agape, open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.